Please take a moment to locate your nearest emergency exit. And out of respect for the artists on stage, as well as the other audience members, we ask that you turn off your cell phones now and refrain from texting during the show. As mandated by federal copyright law, any form of unauthorized recording or photography is strictly prohibited. There will be no intermission. Thank you, and enjoy the performance.
Thank you. James Barnes. It's his Fantasy Variations on a theme by Paganini. Most of you probably know who Paganini is, a very famous violin virtuoso from the early half of the 19th century. And of course, he wrote a very famous set of caprices, and many composers have made variations on his 24th caprice. I'm sure you're all going to recognize the melody when you hear it. This piece does the same thing. It was written for the United States Marine Band back in the 80s. It was designed to feature a lot of soloists in every section. So those of you who know Benjamin Britten's Young Person's Guide to the Orchestra, this piece is basically a very similar type of piece for the same kind of program techniques. It shows off every section in the group, and I think you're going to really enjoy it. I kind of stepped on Andrew's tuning pitch, so go ahead and tune in.
Thank you.
This piece is quite famous because if you're familiar with the Eastman Wind Ensemble and the creation of that in the early 50s and how it changed the wind band world, and the records that came out published by Mercury Records became very important in the wind band history. And this piece was recorded by the Eastman Wind Ensemble, Freddie Finnell conducting. So most of us know him through this piece, but he primarily was active in the radio and television scene in New York City. In fact, he was one of the first African-American composers to work in that environment. He worked for CBS, and for maybe some of you who are maybe a generation beyond me or above me, he was the main staff writer for The Voice of Firestone, which was a very popular show, radio show and television show in the 40s and 50s. Anyway, anybody know that show, by the way? Curiosity. Not only is this a lovely work, but it's very timely for us to take a little autumn walk. Mm-hmm. starting this fall on the faculty at the Manus School in New York in a very broad range of roles, teaching flute, teaching composition, doing some ensemble things. Very important and bright star rising in our future, so look out for all, and keep an eye out for all the pieces and all the wonderful things that Valerie Coleman does. This is a piece she wrote on a commission for a high school band in South Texas. It must be one really good band, because this is a really difficult piece of music. I think you'll enjoy Roma.
Thank you. Thank you.
not in this scene. This is a happy-go-lucky scene as they go out with, on the boat. Everything's good in the world. And then the second half is the scene with the shark cage. If you remember Jaws, where the shark gets the guy in the cage. And anyway, John Williams wrote a wonderful feud for that moment of the film, and that's what this piece does.
Thank you.
encourage you to come to that. It's going to be in the new Atlantic Union Bank Center, which is a new basketball arena. It's going to be on Friday night. Normally it's on Saturday, so don't get fooled, it's on Friday. And it'll be the Wind Symphony starting. We'll be doing the Shostakovich over again, and then, of course, the two John Williams pieces. The JMU Chorale will be singing. The JMU Brass Band will be playing, and then the MRDs, Marching Royal Dukes, will cap off the night. So I hope you can join us for that. We have one more piece for you. We're going to enjoy Airy's Wondrous World.